Hello everyone, how are you? I hope everything is going good, and I welcome you all to my YouTube channel SP Daughters, as well as the video series on univariate descriptive statistics. I'm Gurusha, and right now we are in level 3 section 2 video C, and the topic that we're going to discuss about is the Pareto principle and the ways in order to construct a Pareto chart in Excel, SPSS and in R. Okay, without wasting any more time, let's go into the topic. First of all, what is Pareto chart? A Pareto chart is a chart that has both the bar chart and the line chart combined. We usually use, once again, I hope you all remember this flow chart. In order to describe the qualitative data, we use tables and charts. Under tables, we saw frequency distribution tables in one of our videos. There is a link in the description box below. If you are not yet watched, you can watch from that link. And under charts, we have three. One is bar, other is line, and the last one is Pareto chart. And in this video, we are going to discuss about Pareto chart. And after this, we will be discussing on descriptive statistics for quantitative data. Okay, I hope that's clear. And coming to the Pareto chart. Pareto chart is a chart that combines both bar chart and line chart. This is usually used in order to find out the defects, for example in manufacturing industry, or else the quality check team usually uses the Pareto chart in order to visualize their data, because the main theme of the Pareto chart is the Pareto principle. Pareto principle is nothing but the 80-20 rule or the 80-20 principle. It states that 80% of the effects or 80% of problems are caused by 20% of the factors. It can be said both in positive and negative ways. So first, let me tell you in the negative way. 80% of the problem are caused only by the 20% of factors. Okay? 80% of the customer complaints are only because of the 20% factors. You can understand that way, or else 80% of the problem in the class in 5B is caused only by 20% of the people who are rough and rugged. You can understand that way too. Okay, this is a negative side. It can also be looked in a positive manner. 20% of the effort you put in a work gives you 80% of the result. Let's take the previous example itself. The 80% of problems are caused by 20% of factors, right? So if we focus on only that 20% factors, our 80% problem will be solved. That is, when we devote our time in that 20% factors, we will get 80% of success. Okay, actually this is not an universal law that is it must be 80-20-20-80. It's not like that. It can be 70-30, 90-10, 99-1 also. Okay, but this is the basic concept behind it. And this concept was developed by Wilfred Pareto in 1897. And he was an Italian economist. He told that in Italy, 80% of the wealth was occupied by 20% of the rich people. And 20% of the wealth is spread around 80% of the population of the country. From this, he developed the concept and he found that there exists a principle called 80-20. Okay, that's all for the background. And now let's see how to put a Pareto chart in Excel, SPSS and in R. First, initially Excel. And in Excel, this data set tells us that the total issues reported in the last 6 months in a 5-star hotel. Okay, the issues are registering delays, room service, staff courtesy, minibar and like that. Count is the occurrence of the issue. Number of times the issue has occurred or noticed or complaint or reported. Okay, and in order to construct a Pareto chart, we need something called a relative cumulative frequency. As I said in the beginning of the video, we put bar as well as line chart in the Pareto chart. Okay, and the bar chart represents the count, the absolute frequency, that is the category or the issue, and the absolute frequency will be denoted in the bars. Okay, and the line chart represents the issue and the relative cumulative frequency. Why relative cumulative frequency? You will understand it when we apply this one. For example, I'm going to find out the relative frequency. And before doing this, I'm going to sort the frequency column. In order to do that, I'm going to select the frequency column. In the home tab, I'm going to select sort, and under that, largest to smallest. The reason why I'm choosing the largest to smallest option or the descending order option is because I want the majorly affected factors in the first, in the left hand side. Okay, relative frequency. Okay, first of all, I have to, the sum of these issues is 283 equal to this one divided by 283. I have got this. I'm going to drag it down, and if I press this symbol under home tab under number category, I will get this, like this, the percentage will, I will get the percentage, or else you have to enter the formula as B3 divided by 283 into 100. Okay, and I'm going to find out the running total of relative frequency, relative cumulative frequency. So as I said in one of my videos, that's nothing but equal to this one and equal to the previous frequency plus the upcoming frequency. Drag it till the end, you will get 100. And from this, you can roughly look at one thing, that is the 80%. 80% lies here in the staff courtesy. Before that, there are only three factors, that is registering delays, room service, security services, and staff courtesy. These are the four important complaints and the most frequently occurred complaints. And these complaints are the 80% problem. 80% complaint are only these four. But these four are very less compared. Totally, there are 12 complaints and only these four are the 80% complaints. If we focus on these four, we will be solving the 80% of the company's problem. If I explain with the help of this rough table, it will not be that much easier for you to understand. And for that, I'm going to apply a chart, and that chart is nothing but Pareto chart. I'm going to select this one, and this one. Okay, go to insert, insert combo chart. From that, the second thing, the clustered column line on secondary axis. Click on that, you will get the chart. You can make it bigger even. From here, you can see that x-axis represent the category, and the y-axis on the left hand side represents what? The oh my god, the count, the absolute frequency. Okay, and these two belong to this bar charts, and these two, this one, the x-axis, which is the issue, and this right hand side y-axis represent the relative cumulative frequency. Okay, and our 80% lies somewhere here. And when you draw a line over here, you can see that the major problem causing factors are very less. That is only 20% of the factors causes the 80% of the problem, and that 20% of the factors are room service, registering delays, security services, and staff courtesy. And when you focus on these 20% factors, you can solve your 80% problem. Okay, that's all in Excel. Now let's move on to SPSS. And yeah, in SPSS, it's nothing but go to graphs and then select chart builder, and the chart builder dialog box appears. Okay, before this, usually a dialog box appears, and that asks you for whether you have given the proper measurement levels. Measurement levels is nothing but, there are four types of measurement levels. One is nominal, ordinal, interval, and ratio. We have already discussed all that in our video series. Let me give the link in the description box below. If you want, you can check it that as well. And please look at this icon, this symbol. It means that the measurement level has already defined, and the measurement level is nominal. Okay. So I need not worry, but if you've not yet defined a measurement level, there will be a dialog box appeared. Okay, and in that dialog box, you can choose define variable properties, and from that you can select the variable that you want to define the measurement for, and you can click continue, and in that you can select the measurement levels, and then again come back to this chart builder. Okay, sometimes there will be a pop-up of that dialog box before this chart builder appears. Okay, then from here, go to gallery, and from this one, dual axis, you can select this. because this is the Pareto chart. Has dual axis, one is for a bar chart, another is for pie. Select at this Pareto chart and drag it to this area. Yeah, you can see here that there are two y-axis and one x-axis. Obviously, x-axis represent the category, and this bar represent what? Bars represent the count or the absolute frequency. So I'm going to select the bar, and from this statistics area I'm going to select count. Click on the line chart, and from the statistics area you can select cumulative percentage. Okay, click OK. The Pareto chart will be displayed. But one thing is here, the chart looks so funny. Why? Because that the Pareto chart is not sorted in descending order. In order to do that, click on the chart twice, and from here again click on the bar. Okay, why? Because you wanna sort the values of the bar, right? So click on the bar, and from here in the categories tab, in the sort by section, select statistic, and in the direction you can select either ascending or descending, but usually we will choose descending. Why? Because we must first look at the highly defected factor. Okay, so descending, click on apply. Yeah, we got it. And if you want data labels, as I said in one of my videos, go to this blue color icon so that the data labels will be displayed. That's all in SPSS. Okay, now I'm in the R environment, and here what I'm going to do is I'm going to assign a variable for the issues column in the Pareto for SPSS dataset. Okay, so I'm going to assign the variable as issues itself. Issues equal to Pareto for SPSS dollar issues. Okay, it means that this term issues, or the variable issue, refers to the issues column in the Pareto for SPSS data set. Okay, then after this, what I'm going to do is I'm going to construct a frequency distribution for the issues column. I'm going to give it count of supposed to give spaces rather than an underscore. Count of issues equal to table of, table is the command in order to find out the absolute frequency, so table of issues, the issues column. Okay, and I'm going to use a package called QCC. If you have not yet installed the package, please install like this: install.packages of, in under double quotes, give QCC and press enter with the internet connection. Okay, I've already installed, so I'm not going to run the command. And if you've done the installation, go with this command: Pareto.chart chart of what? This count of issues, right? Count of issues. Press enter, and here you can look at the chart. Okay, that's all for this video. See y'all in the next video. Bye bye.